Hi there. Today I'm going to broach the huge topic of animal testing. Now this is something I'm going to have to address over a series of videos because this topic has so many facets. Today we're going to focus on the question, is animal testing effective and does it save lives? The technical term for this is vivisection. Vivisection is the act of cutting, drugging, burning, blinding, shocking, addicting, shooting, freezing, infecting, and surgically mutilating live animals. Yes, this includes dissecting animals while they are fully conscious. Now there are some forms of animal testing that most people can get behind as being unnecessary. This includes those that evaluate the toxicity of consumer products and their ingredients. I mean, most people can agree that spraying toxic cleaners and jabbing mascara into the eyes of bunnies to see if it's a bad idea for humans to do so to themselves is rather stupid. Where most people get stuck, however, is animal testing for medical advances. Torturing animals for lip gloss is one thing, but when we're talking about possible cures for diseases, the line of acceptable evil begins to blur for many people. So just what happens in these medical experiments? Monkeys are addicted to drugs, cats are deafened and have holes drilled into their skulls, sheep and pigs have their skin burned off, and rats have their spinal cords crushed. Tiny mice are made to grow tumors nearly as large as their entire bodies. Kittens are purposefully blinded, and rats are made to suffer seizures. Dogs are intentionally poisoned with experimental drugs, chimpanzees are infected with debilitating diseases, and rabbits have grotesque devices implanted into their bodies. Now, certainly we wouldn't be doing all of these horrific things if it wasn't effective, right? I mean, we have to be saving lives with these awful methods. Otherwise, there'd be no reason. On his website, adapt.org, Gary Yourofsky writes about having spoken to veterinarians who believe that animal testing is beneficial to humans. He says, I asked them, when you were in vet school studying feline leukemia, which animal did you study upon? They all replied, cats. I asked them why they didn't use dogs for feline leukemia research. They replied that studying dogs for feline leukemia didn't make too much sense scientifically. I then asked why dogs, cats, or any other animals are used for human leukemia research. Their silence exposed the scam. In this very same article, Gary cites Dr. Jerry Vlasic, a trauma surgeon and one of the world's grittiest animal rights activists. Dr. Vlasic actually performed vivisection in his training as a medical doctor, but is now passionately against it. In his own article, Dr. Vlasic says, on a daily basis, animals are drowned, suffocated, and starved to death. They have their limbs severed and their organs crushed. They are burned, exposed to radiation, and used in experimental surgeries. They are shocked, raised in isolation, exposed to weapons of mass destruction, and rendered blind or paralyzed. They are given heart attacks, ulcers, paralysis, and seizures. They are forced to inhale tobacco smoke, drink alcohol, and ingest various drugs like heroin and cocaine. And speaking about his introduction to the world of vivisection, Dr. Vlasic says, I learned that 85% of all the data gathered from animal experiments was literally thrown away because it was of no use to anyone, human or non-human, never even published, much less used to help people. Almost all the remainder of this data was never found useful for human healthcare. I learned that the 1 or 2% of data that was possibly, one day, maybe going to be useful in helping people could have been obtained more accurately and cheaply using modern, progressive, non-animal methods. Drugs that may be effective in animals may not be effective or even safe in humans. But what about primates that share 99% of our DNA? Because evolution, molecular biology, and genetics show that animals and humans differ in profoundly important ways, animal models will never be able to accurately recapitulate what happens in the human condition. And in fact, there are many examples of where research derived from animal testing has seriously harmed humans. This is something that I'll address in another video. To put it simply, when you need medical treatment, do you want something that works for you or something that works for a completely different species? Now, beyond the whole argument of whether it's effective or ethical is the fact that there are alternatives to animal testing. For example, there's human skin equivalents. These methods consist of normal human-derived skin cells that have been cultured to form a multi-layered model of human skin. As you can see, taking ethics out of the entire equation of animal testing, all the research and evidence points to the fact that animal testing is simply not effective, and not only does not save human lives, but harms them. Now, if animal testing were effective, it would be something that we could not oppose on scientific grounds. However, because vivisection itself is faulty science, it's something that can be opposed on moral, ethical, and scientific grounds. It simply doesn't work. Thanks for tuning in for the nugget, and keep an eye out for future videos on other aspects of animal testing. And if this was a bit too serious for you, here's some footage of a baby possum that lives outside my house, chowing down on some food with a neighborhood cat. Please visit BiteSizeVegan.com and sign up for the newsletter for free updates, exclusives, and to never miss a nugget. And be sure to subscribe to the channel, as well as watch all of the BiteSizeVegan nuggets on the BiteSizeVegan Nugget playlist.